Hi, this is Mike Bale. I'm with Bangern Inc. In this series of videos, we're going to go through the configuration and setup for sales and use tax within Sage Intacct Construction. More specifically, this first video here is going to just go through a brief overview of the process and what we're going to be going through in the subsequent sessions. What we're going to do right now is go through a brief PowerPoint to start and just kind of go through the outline of what the next courses are going to take you through within this setup and configuration. So as far as the tax setup for Sage Intacct, we recommend turning on what's called advanced or enabling advanced tax. And we're going to talk more specifically about this as we move along here in this system. But basically what advanced tax allows you to do is it allows you to automatically calculate the sales tax inside Sage Intacct when processing accounts receivable invoices or accounts payable bills throughout the system. And mainly our focus is going to be using it through the transaction definition module. So through the setup of order entry and the purchasing module. You can also set up sales tax directly in accounts receivable. But for these business cases and uses that we're going to be discussing more specifically in the construction environment, chances are, if you need to track sales tax, it's going to be always flowing through either order entry and or purchasing. So even your construction billings and your free form invoices on the accounts receivable side are going to happen through the order entry setup. So our main focus is going to be these two modules here. So you can use them in order entry and purchasing for advanced sales tax, and you can enable it based on what and where you need to track this. So maybe you need to set up and charge sales tax for your accounts receivable customer invoices, but you don't need to track it on the purchasing side, or vice versa. Maybe you don't invoice sales tax, all your projects are exempt, but you need to track sales use tax on the purchasing side. So you're going to be able to turn these on and off based on your specific needs and where you need them. Now, as we go through these sessions, we're going to go into some configuration and setup, and you're going to see the first area that we're going to go into is what we call shared configuration. So these are settings and lists that can be set up once and that can be used across both order entry and purchasing. And then there's going to be some what I call module specific setup that you're going to need different lists, different configurations for each of those areas. You're going to need a scheduling mapping for order entry sales tax rules versus a scheduling mapping for purchasing mapping rules. So we'll go into each one of those sessions and kind of go through first the shared configuration and then anything that is module specific. So talking a little further on the shared setup, one of the first areas we're going to go through in the next videos is this shared setup. So we're going to go and actually discuss setting up what is called contact tax groups. And these are going to be the specific localities or areas, whether they're state counties or states themselves, all your different variations of what types of tax groups you have for your customers and your vendors. So just to kind of give you a point of reference for those that have used Sage 300, CRE, or Timberline in the past, these are going to be your tax groups that you would set up there. And these can be used across both purchasing and order entry. You don't need separate groups for these. And then we're also going to talk about what is called item tax groups. So you're going to have the ability to set up your items in both order entry and purchasing. And you're going to be able to establish whenever you use that particular item or line item, is that specific line item taxable or not? Simplest example would be material is taxable, but labor isn't. So you can actually have an item tax group called not taxable for labor, but have it taxable for material. And then when we get into the individual schedules, you'll see how that's all put together. And again, we're going to go into this in more detail in the next sessions. One of the other areas that is actually shared across the modules is what's called tax authorities. So this is where you're going to report and pay or request refunds for your sales tax that you have collected or that you have paid or that you are supposed to pay. These tax authorities would be most common setup would be your states. So we're going to pay sales tax to the state of Missouri, state of Iowa. You're going to set up tax authorities for those states, and we're going to be able to link them to a vendor in accounts payable. So we'll go through that setup as well. And then we're going to get into the next sessions after that. We're going to get into module-specific setup. So from that point on, we're going to go in and, you know, have specific setups in order entry versus purchasing. So tax details, this is where your tax percentages are going to be stored. So if you have the same county, both on the purchasing and order entry side or sales side, we're actually going to set up two tax details, one called order entry county and one called purchasing county, whatever we want to call it. But we're going to need separate specific setups for that. And then the same thing on what we call scheduling and scheduling maps. These are basically the rules that are put together that says if this customer is in this tax area, tax group, and the item is taxable and it's order entry, then they're going to get this tax detail. So we're going to put it all together in these mappings, and they're very flexible to be able to handle all of your different scenarios and criteria for your rules. So we'll get into that with schedules and schedule mappings. Now, as far as what you can do inside those areas, they're going to be the same as far as the screens look, but you're going to need separate lists for order entry side and a separate list for the purchasing side. And then we're going to specifically go back into the transaction definitions that you have in your system right now based on the order entry and purchasing side. So a lot of people will have a common one on the construction side is our project contracts transaction definition. So in there, you know, we're going to want to enable subtotals, and there's some configuration on that subtotal so that we can have the tax lines prefill in the subtotal section. And that could be different for each transaction definition. Maybe one we don't turn on and one we do. Okay, so we're going to go into that as well. And then again, it's specific to each module. And then, of course, within the customer and vendor setups, you're going to have the ability through contacts to apply default contact tax groups, which we talked about in the shared settings, and that'll kind of let the system know when that contact is used or location is used, it's taxable for this customer versus not. And we'll talk about that and get into that. And then we'll have an additional session at the end for use tax reporting and consideration inside the system. If you don't pay use sales tax, but you are required to report it and track your usage and also cost it to the project, we'll be able to do that with the use tax consideration. So what we'll do now to end this session in the overview is we're actually going to go in and we're going to show you where you need to first enable advanced tax. So we need to see if you have that enabled in your instance. And that is going to be done inside the configuration settings of either order entry or purchasing. It's actually the same location. You can enable it based on which module you need to turn it on for. So let's go take a look at that. I'm going to end this show. And I'm going to jump over to my instance, and I'm in my demo instance. And I'm going to go into order entry, and I'll go to setup, configuration. And once you're in that area, as you scroll down here, you're going to see a section for tax. So you're going to want to make sure that use advanced tax schedules is checked off. So go ahead and check that off. You know, if it's not, it'll probably tell you, hey, you know, there's some changes that can't be made once you turn this on. That's okay. Go ahead and make sure that is checked off. And more importantly, go ahead and go into the question mark next to the use advanced tax schedules. So if you click on that, it gives you a little explanation of what we're talking about today. And what I find very helpful is this advanced tax overview page in the help. You can also get to it by searching under the help and support here. But if you click on the advanced tax overview, this is going to be kind of your outline, exactly what we're doing in this session today. It can take you step by step through the process. I use it as a reference all the time. Just helps me make sure I've gone through all the steps. So, you know, basically we've talked about this here with advanced. This goes into each module. You can certainly go through accounts receivable, but again, if your point of entries are order entry or through the projects module, you're going to need to set it up through what's called order entry and purchasing. So it tells you specifically for order entry, here's what you need to do. And it's really what we just talked about in that outline on the PowerPoint. So we need customers, items, contact tax groups. We're going to go into that in the next session. Item tax groups. These are exactly the steps that we just talked about. So you can use this for a reference here. And then it also goes into down here, hey, make sure there's some additional configuration in the transaction definition. So I'll keep this handy. You can bookmark it, but just know you can always get back into it by typing in the help, advanced tax, and then go to the overview. And then as we go through these other sessions, you're going to see us kind of using these as well to get more specific and drill down in more details on what you need to do. So that's going to wrap up the advanced sales tax overview session. Thank you.